Hey guys, welcome back to another video. Today I have a very special announcement, and it's that we have a new host for our YouTube channel. Now do not worry, I'm not going anywhere. We are just trying to put more content for you guys as we are trying to diversify. So you will still see me at least once a week doing plant tissue culture. However, our new host, Shay from Microdesk Mushroom, is an expert on the art of growing mushrooms. He's currently growing over 40 species of gourmet and medicinal mushrooms using techniques that you can easily follow from your own house. So this is it for me for today. Let's welcome Shay down in the comments and let's see what he has for us today.
What's up guys? Shay from Microdesk Mushrooms here over in the PCT Labs in Washington, DC. And today I'm gonna be showing you guys how to make some agar. It's pretty easy. You're gonna need a few things. We're gonna go over that. And the reason that we're making this is so that we can start growing out our mycelium. And so before we start anything, we need to expand the amount of mycelium that we have. We're starting from like a single petri dish, and then after our inoculations, we're gonna expand it to possibly hundreds of plates. We're gonna see how many we can get out of this batch. So yeah, let's get started. So we're gonna start with a really basic recipe of just water. We're gonna use distilled water here, 1,000 milliliters. And we're just gonna pour that into our beaker. So that's 1,000. We're gonna drop a magnetic stir in to stir up 40 grams of honey. And we're just gonna take that and pour it into the mixture after turning our stir bar on, just so we can help dissolve all the sugar. And the reason we're doing 40 grams to 1,000 milliliters is because it brings you to a perfect 4% sugar. And fungi thrive at 4%. And we're also gonna need 3 grams of gallon gum, which is what we're gonna use today, or 6 grams of agar. And that just gives the perfect consistency to hold the media into like a solid jelly so that we can make cuts, precision cuts from it. And so after our two ingredients are dissolved, we're gonna add them into our media pour bottles and sterilize them for 30 minutes at 15 PSI. And the reason we're doing that is just to kill off any contaminants before we pour our plates so that when we grow our mycelium on the plates, they're the only things that are there. We don't want any competitors. Sometimes I notice that when I use food dye, it can kind of disrupt the mycelium. So in one of these bottles, I'm gonna test that. So I'm pouring 500 milliliters into one. And 500 into the other. I do like 2 drops, it depends on how dark you want the mixture to be. I kind of want it to be clear. So I'm just gonna put 1. And just to mix it up, as we can, I'm gonna throw the stir bar back in. Mix that up real quick. And we're good to go. I'm just gonna put the cap. Well, I'm gonna take the stir bar out first. There we go. Put our caps on. And we're gonna put these on loosely. Cover them with foil. Awesome. So we're gonna put these in the pressure cooker now.
Once your agar is done sterilizing, you can take it out of the pot and wait until it cools to about 50 Celsius or until it's easy to hold. Try to aim for an equal amount of media per plate just so your fungi all have the same lifespan because the agar is their life source. Once they run out or it dries up, the mycelium will die with it, so just keep that in mind when you're storing. You can store these in the fridge but you can also just keep them out on the counter. But yeah, this was Shay of Microdex Mushrooms signing out. I'll see you guys in the next one where we inoculate these.